All right, party people, you are watching Grand Theft Audio on Zynna.tv, the name that shall stand the test of time. My name is Jake Belcher, and I am in studio with...
Brant Thoman.
And we're excited you guys have joined us here today. We've got a real fun show, got some interesting topics to talk about. We have some fun guests that we'll have in for later segments.
Indeed.
Yeah, it'll be a good time. So let's kick it off, man. How was your week?
It's been all right. I mean,
anything particularly good?
No, nothing particularly. Well, that's not true. In the last week, I've gotten to do two of those Ultimate Jam nights, and both nights have been fun. Last night was especially good.
Yeah, it was pretty dope. This is like our other job. We produced a show called Ultimate Jam Night Live at the Whiskey, and last night's show was dope.
Oh, it was. The mustache show, Southern rock. Great songs, and just, I mean, really great performances, I think, on every single song. Every once in a while, there's one you sit there and go, oh, that was all right. But
that is his thoughts only. Like, I'd fire him for thinking like that. Every song is superb.
Yes.
How dare you, sir?
Indeed. So, but besides that, I don't think so. What about you? Anything particularly great happened this week?
Yeah, something amazing happened, and I'll get into it in this top segment. But I want to get into, like, the big thing that's happened in the world since we were in here last week.
Okay.
That's grab her by the pussy.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, so what are your feelings on that, man? Like, when you watch that and you see that, like, everyone... Okay, so I don't mean to just focus on you and your feelings.
No, I understand.
But people are losing their shit over this.
Yeah, they are. They are.
Like, to a ridiculous level.
Absolutely. I think last night we realized that it's not really locker room kind of conversations. It's
because these conversations happen more than just in locker rooms.
Well, not so much that. I think they more frequently happen in places like we were, like in the back parking lot where there's no women around whatsoever who can hear it. There's nobody else who's listening in. And, you know,
it's
the vulgarity.
It's a silly excuse to call it locker room talk.
Yes, absolutely.
But honestly,
But it's definitely guy talk.
Okay, so this whole thing is a problem that, like, Donald Trump... When, like, a lady lets him know that she's interested, I mean, because that's the context that it's actually put in there. It's not just walk up to a girl and grab her by her pussy. It's like the girls throw themselves at you when you're famous, and, like, you can just grab them by the pussy. Honestly, like, okay, this is maybe kind of a little bit fucked up, but I've been grabbed by the dick by many ladies many times.
Right.
You know, like,
and probably
many, many times, like, because I had something that they want. And honestly, I think that ladies, I think Donald Trump, has something that a lot of ladies want. Like, not only does he have, you know, fame and everything that goes on with that, but I think he's also rich.
Yes.
And honestly, like, I know a bunch of girls from talking that they would do way worse things to be with, like, a billionaire.
Absolutely.
So this outrage that is being about is pretty ridiculous.
Sure, sure.
I'm not a fan.
I don't think this stuff is unsolicited.
Yeah,
I mean,
right,
the his actions. I think there's always flirtation that goes on. I'm sure for him.
That guy walks into a room and there's 50 women that want to be with him.
Right.
I mean, because they know he's a rich and powerful person.
Indeed.
And I know girls that exist like this. You will never convince me that they don't exist.
Yes.
Ever.
Neither one of us stand a chance against someone who has wealth and power.
Well, I do. I mean, I have personality.
Well,
and, like,
absolutely.
I mean, there's other things I can do to, like, trick it to come home with me instead.
Potentially.
But
is there a stronger aphrodisiac?
I am not generally in the position where I am. I can go up and grab a girl by her pussy.
Right.
But honestly, many, 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 many women have just walked up to me and, like, grabbed my dick because they want something. That happens all the fucking time.
All the time.
Okay, it happens often enough.
Often enough.
That I will not... You can't convince me that you know, it's not a legitimate thing that happens in my life. It happens.
Sure.
So, I mean, I don't... As we all know, I'm voting for Hillary Clinton because I'm a man of my word and I made the agreement that I would vote for her. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to do what I can to convince you people that you should vote for Donald Trump. So don't let this distract you. Like, there's all sorts of reasons to dislike people, but this is fairly regular human behavior. I mean, honestly, like, I understand that we can get mad about it and that they can edit clips together and they can make things seem as bad as possible, but they have to make these things up and make it the attacking point because they don't have anything else to really go after him on. He doesn't have a history of, you know, selling out America and all these other
wonderful
things that we have going on.
Right. He just doesn't pay his taxes. because of the loopholes they found.
Sure.
So legally gets out of paying taxes.
Yeah, that's right. Just like every smart person does. If you know anybody who pays more taxes than they're supposed to, or that they are, you know, that they can get it down to, that person's a goddamn moron.
Yep.
Hey, honestly, how much extra did you leave on the plate last year just because, like, got to leave a little fat on the bone for Uncle Sam?
Just a little bit.
No, you really left some extra on there?
I did not get every penny back.
Oh.
I got
you
very
tried
close.
To get every penny.
I tried to, absolutely.
Because you're not a moron.
Because my expenses from the previous year were different than this year, yeah. I did not incur as many deductions. Mm-hmm. So thusly, they were able to hold on to a little bit more than usual.
Did you step back and be like, let's just give them like 5% more just because we need it for our roads and we need it for the police?
You know what? Who marks?
No one does that.
Well, okay, when you're registering to vote, who marks that? I'd like to give a dollar. Who checks that? I don't want to give anybody a dollar. You already take those dollars from my check. Yeah. Take it from that, please.
That's right. No one checks that box.
Nobody.
I don't believe it.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't want to get all fun political rants here at the beginning of the show, but this whole Pussygate is not that big of a deal.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't have one that I have to defend to know what that feeling is like, I guess. I can't put myself in the lady's mindset and be like, well, what would that mean to me? But I can say that the opposite exists.
Sure.
That ladies are dick grabbers when they want things from you. It happens all the time. Like, it happens with, not me now, because I'm with someone who, is very even and stuff. But in the past, like, in the relationship with, like, a girl that you're with, like, if she wants something out of you, like, you gotta, like, go do the dishes or something, she'll grab your dick to get you to go do it.
Yes, but, okay, now here's the thing.
Because you have something that they want.
Right, and they're already comfortable doing that. If you have a girlfriend who comes up and grabs your dick, it's...
I had non-girlfriends grab my dick for things many times.
Right.
So,
but with the understanding that there would be something.
Yeah, that's right. They want something.
Right.
You know, like,
but you knew these women ahead of time.
No.
Really? Where women have just
strange ladies. Not to the point that, like, it was just like I looked at her and then she ran over and grabbed my dick.
Right.
But within the first 5 to 10 minutes of our conversation or something like that, she's let me know that she likes something from me, and now she's grabbing my dick, letting me realize what could happen if I went that way.
Right.
So it happens and it exists. That's what I got. Okay. Let's talk about the funny thing that happened to me this week.
Sure.
This week, I went to, it's called Magic Mountains Fright Fest.
Mm-hmm.
I went with my wife.
Six Flags Park, correct?
Yeah, Flags Park. Really, really nice, really fun. We went out for their Fright Fest, like where they come out with guys like sliding along on the ground and with a chainsaw without the chain on, and they try to scare the wits out of you.
Right.
Well, anyways, they also have some great rides that we haven't been on since we got our passes there.
Right.
We decided we're going to go take our first ride on Twisted Colossus. Now, Twisted Colossus is this roller coaster that they built in the frame of the burnt-down old Colossus.
Right.
So it's not quite as big as it used to be, but incredible ride. It's the best roller coaster I've ever been on. It had us going every direction, man. Like, it was incredible.
Well, halfway through, thusly twisted. It must really be all over the place. You're all over the place.
Midway through the ride, my wife says to me, my bra came undone. And I'm like, what? You know, like, I mean, I know that, like, this ride's kind of going everywhere, but I didn't think it could be enough to, like, dislodge one from their clothing.
Right.
So I'm still riding along like an idiot. Whee! And she's trying to, like, twist on herself and, like, try to put things back together before we pull into the station. We get into the station. She stands up, and, like, her butt cheeks are hanging out of her pants, which I've never seen happen once in, like, the entire time we've been together. She's a very dignified and classy lady, and that's not the way that
absolutely.
She lives.
Absolutely. But apparently for this ride, you know, it had its way with her.
Yeah. It tossed her all over the place.
And undressed her. And you know, apparently filled up her ass a little bit.
It did more than that. Somehow it also knocked the wallet out of her pants.
Ooh.
She says to me, I've lost my wallet. So, like, the cart hadn't gone out, so I went over and I looked. And I didn't see it. And they're like, we're sorry. You have to go to guest relations, and they'll tell you, like, how to put this all together and, like, get your stuff back. And I was like, okay, man. So we walk all the way across the park. We get to the other side, and like, there's nothing we can really do until 3 in the morning. Like, if you want to wait around, you can see if they find it when they walk the track once the ride is over. Or you can just go online, which is what we suggest, and you tell the people online that, like, we will –
You fill out a form, and this is what I lost, and this is what I'm looking for.
So you'll get it.
Right.
So we're like, okay, it's not really worth it till 3 in the morning. We will just fill out this form tomorrow.
Right.
So we're wandering around, still having a good time. We decided to go on another ride, and we get on this ride called Green Lantern's First Flight.
Right.
When you look at it from the side, it's super flat. You can see it's just a bunch of twists that's going to happen. Like, it's one of these roller coasters where you're spinning around and going along the track. So, like, you're all over the place.
Right.
We come up to the very front. They put you like you're going to blast off. And they instantly flip you in a circle. And all I hear is, my glasses! Because, like, instantly, on the first turn, her glasses come off of her head. And now she's riding along and she can't see anything. And we get off the ride, and she tries to cause, like, a ruckus. Like, somehow they're going to shut down the ride, and she's going to...
Because she can't see.
Because she can't see, you know? So, needless to say, that was not in their plans. They sent us to the same place, and they told us, come back at 3 in the morning after they've walked the tracks, and we'll see if we can find it. So, long story short, we weren't going to wait for just the wallet, but now that it's wallet and glasses, we got, like, a, you know, there's a chance that, like, we'll get one of two things.
And this is at what time in the evening?
Okay, so this is about midnight.
So okay, so it's not like it happened at 9 o'clock in the evening, and now she's going glasses, glassesless.
Right, I'm walking her through this park where all these things are jumping out and trying to scare her, and she can't see shit. Like, it's just fucking terrible. So anyways, we find a bench to sit on and just wait it out, and finally we get through like the line because there's a whole bunch of people who lost things, and they didn't find her glasses, they didn't find her wallet, but they did recover her driver's license.
That's a bonus. I mean, at least it's that. I mean,
sure. I'm not saying it's a funny thing that happened. I mean, we tried to laugh our way through it on Saturday night, but it was funny.
In hindsight, yes. It's absolutely hilarious.
You're right about that.
Absolutely.
All right, we're going to go to our first break. We're going to come back on the other side of it with a couple of young filmmakers. They're going to let us know about their project, and we'll have a chance to delve into what all that is and, you know, that jazz. So come back in 2 minutes, guys.
Did you know that 67% of American women are size 14 and above?
You mean they look like this?
Yeah, girl.
So then where are we in television and film?
And where are we in fashion magazines and clothing stores?
Yeah.
So we want to help out entertainment and fashion and media.
Catch the F up.
Watch us on Plus This.
Live.
Every Thursday.
At 7 p.m.
on Zena TV.
This is Quick Fix Radio.
Quick Fix Radio.
Yeah. Check it out, y'all. We back in the building. What's going on?
Yes, sir. What it do? We got some super guests, super special guests up in the place,
in
man.
In the building, we got all five live in the building. Bone Thugs in the building.
All
everybody.
Five here,
live
we here,
in the
we
house
up in here.
Tonight, y'all.
Not
what's going on?
Hey, man, I had to come see what this TV radio one, what this all about. You know what I'm saying? Hey.
We got Game on the line. Game, what's going down, baby?
What up? What's
going on? Oh man, we got EPMD. Who is this on the phone with us?
Yo, what up, man? It's Akon.
Oh, Akon in the building. Akon. Who is this on the line?
It's Be Real.
We got Be Real.
Be Real.
Who is we got on the line?
This Ty Dolla Sign right here.
What up, Ty Dolla Sign in the building. Thanks to all the fans for stopping by.
The Quick Fix with Crazy Bone. Right here on T Radio V.
Money,
in the booth. A man in the booth. Quit telling me what to do, man. I don't need that. Like, you try to give me like the countdown, like it doesn't exist or something. Play that. I don't know. I'm just fucking around. No, he's really good at his job. But sometimes I'm just a dick. Welcome back to the Dick Show. This is Jake.
And I'm Brant.
And, okay, so I told you guys we have some, hey, you put your headphones on. I can actually hear myself being a dick. It's wonderful.
Yes.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I think you skipped that the
first. Dude,
I think
I'm in stereo, Dick. This is this is incredible.
Dick's going into both ears, huh?
Whoa. I don't know about that, man. That sounds
sure.
That sounds Trumponian. Like, I'm not going to vote for you now.
Oh, good.
Two dicks in your ears. Like, what would the children think? All right, we're back here on The Dick Show. And once again, this is Jake Belcher.
And I'm Brant Thoman.
Oh, and I thought you were going to say you were a dick.
No.
No, who's the dick?
You're the dick.
That's right. We could both agree on that.
Indeed.
God damn.
At least at that point.
Yeah.
For the most part, you're not.
What about this point?
Yes, now you're being a dick.
Okay, great.
Because just being, you don't point. Dicks don't point.
They do, unless, like, yours is broken and it just flops to the ground all day. Like,
sure, it's just pointing at the ground. You're absolutely
even
right.
That's barely pointing. I mean, that's kind of...
Yeah.
So let's not think about unhard dicks.
Sure.
Let's only think about pointing dicks.
Okay. I just want to make sure I'm yes. focused on what we're supposed to be thinking about right
yes.
now.
Okay. So what are you thinking about?
Apparently...
No, not apparently. What are you thinking about?
Well, unfortunately, it's been shoved into my mind.
Yes.
Hard dicks.
Wow.
Hard pointy dicks.
You have
dicks.
A problem, sir.
I know.
Here we are trying to be a family show.
Since when? In the eight
since
years
that
we've
sentence, since that sentence started.
Okay, so after the sentence, the last sentence in which "dick"
yes.
was said, until
yes.
right now when I said "dick" again.
Wow. Yeah, that's right.
Great.
You probably got us two FCC violations there.
Okay.
Wow. Selfish.
I know.
Selfish.
If only they controlled the online airwaves.
You know what, man? I think we need a reset.
Sure.
Okay. Here's what we're gonna do. We are going to play a clip from a movie that our guests are here for. And then we'll come on the other side, and we won't be the Dick Show anymore. We'll be the Jake and Brant on Grand Theft Audio being pleasant people show. Does that sound reasonable, sir?
Is that how we're going to announce ourselves?
Yes, exactly like that.
Okay, I got to get used to the name. Grand Theft Audio has been hard enough for the last
sure,
8 years.
Sure,
so.
Sure. But we're going to come back on the other side, and we will be the...
Jake and Brant on the Grand Theft Audio Pleasant People Show.
Sounds good.
There you go.
All right, let's watch this clip.
Where is everybody?
That's awesome.
That was awesome.
All right, that's a clip from I Had a Bloody Good Time at House Harker.
Yes.
And we have a bunch of the people who are responsible for that. We're going to work our way across from your left to your right as we have Jacob Givens.
Hello.
We have Clayton Cogswell.
Hello.
And Noel Carroll.
Thanks for having us.
How you guys doing?
Good.
Great. Great.
Fantastic.
Dick, and Dick.
Yes.
So.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah,
sure.
Good. Yes.
Sure, but I mean,
three hard dicks.
You would have been great on our last show, but on our new show...
Oh, right. No. Yes. This is Jake and Brant on Grand Theft Audio show of pleasant people.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, pleasant.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
Ah,
we
family
no longer,
show.
Lovely.
We no longer prefer the hard dicks.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
as
no,
you can see
no.
from our clip, we are very family friendly.
Sure.
Sure.
Film.
I saw a bunch of like pop.
Yeah.
Like bursting bloody thingies that goes.
Yeah. Horror. That's a fun genre. And that looks like it's a fun film as well. Like, I guess one thing about horror, it can't take itself too seriously, right?
Correct. Yeah, absolutely.
For it to work.
Honestly, I think that's what we tried to go make a scary, scary movie, and we failed miserably. But we're pretty good at is comedy, and you know, we kind of figure the greatest form of entertainment is something that just makes people go, oh, that was cool, and that's kind of fun. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of what this movie ended up being.
It's a big party, for sure.
Yeah.
It's a big party. It's a fun movie. It kind of harkens back to the 80s and the fun vampire flicks back then, so
definitely the B movie vampire flicks that they would make, absolutely. Yeah.
Totally. When you've got very little money, you have to focus on something. We thought fun was a good way to go.
And they do say that they like the horror films, and I'm sure comedic horror films are a lot less expensive to produce than say a drama or an actual comedy. So
yeah, definitely.
I mean, it's a great way to get out there in this industry. So, but I know you guys do other stuff, but. Now, where have you guys been with this? I know that it's only recently been like run in a couple of different film festivals.
We premiered in Madrid, Spain, at Nocturna Madrid.
Oh, crazy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's a really cool festival they have out there.
And
did
one.
Did you go out to it?
Yes.
Whoa,
we
cool,
all did. Yeah,
cool.
And we won Best Film Audience Award. So
good job.
Yeah,
and we also got a special mention for being actually going
exactly
off
what
the,
you're talking
about. What are they called?
Throwback to the 80s.
Like trauma films.
It's cool that there are still film festivals that are going to recognize that style.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, we're so used to our award ceremonies or award seasons being just the very best of the best.
Right.
I know there's the Golden Raspberries, and that's the most famous one of them, but there are so many great film festivals. After Spain?
Then we went to Germany.
Nice.
Fantasy Film Fest, which is a really, it's an awesome festival. It goes through the whole country.
It's been around for 30 years.
Yeah, it's one of the longest running genre film festivals. And it goes to all their major cities, and it went really well. Sold out the theaters. It's cool. Right Said Fred. You guys remember the old guy?
Exactly.
So they put a couple of their songs and remixed them for us in the movie. Yeah. So they actually they're big fans of the city of Hamburg. So they came out and they actually joined us, and we're out there for the thing, and that was pretty rad.
So we
people still love them there, man.
Oh, yeah. And we watched the movie with them, and then we got to go out and drink with them for a couple hours. And I'm a fan for life because they're
cool.
Just the best. They're
such
great guys.
Did their song like happen to come on the radio? Like
no, but we did talk. About it though, I did have a little anecdote that I had to tell him, and he thought it was really funny about I'm Too Sexy. So
that's cool, man. Yeah. Before we go further though, what roles did you guys have with the film? Like, Jacob, what did you do?
I'm the screenwriter, and I play Jerry Harker in the movie. That was me up there getting a load of blood in my face.
Ropes and ropes of blood.
Ropes and ropes.
Yeah.
We don't know what that means.
No, this is family show, guys.
You're remembering
new
show. No, we've had to toss that out the
door.
It's
a new show. Right. This is friendly now.
Sure, that's right. How about you, Clayton?
I directed the picture, and I also edited it as well.
Cool.
So, yeah.
Noel?
I produced it, and I played Charlie, who was the nerd in glasses at the end there.
Yeah.
As a side note, I was watching the trailer for it, and all of a sudden, like, my uncle-in-law came across the movie because he's Arlen, who has a role in this as well. So,
that's right.
Small world.
Yeah, I remember sitting around at Thanksgiving, I think last year, and he's telling me, like, how great this was. And he was like, oh, I go on these sets, and I know that these projects aren't going to be that great, but when you do this, you can just see this is going to be, like, a lot of fun, and I'm really proud of this work. And I'm like, oh, that's cool, man. Then I was just watching it, and he came across. I'm like, that's incredible.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So
that's
awesome.
Is Arlen
so
really
good.
Your uncle-in-law?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, seriously?
For legit, man.
Totally. And my absolutely had no idea.
And my real life brother played the younger
version
of Arlen.
Yeah, I knew that.
So, oh my God, the 6 degrees of separation.
Right. So we're kind of related Nish now.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, legitimately, Arlen
no idea.
Yeah, is my uncle.
And did you know that you and I went to the same high school?
Sure.
But way back in the day, in like the late 60s.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Locking out of high school.
Yeah. That's right. That's right.
And Brent went there as well.
Yep.
That's right.
I do remember Noel from back then. I was kind of like a jerk.
No, you were a hero.
No, Jake, you were a dick.
Sure. I was a dick to people who deserved it.
No, you were kind of a drama god, if there is such a thing. I mean, really, you were like that hilarious senior that everybody was like.
It takes
so
a
funny.
Very special student to do 5 years of drama at one high school.
You're right, man. Hey, honestly, like, okay, so long-term listeners know it took me 5 years to get out of high school.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
like, but I'm the record holder. Dench.
That's like a doctorate in high school.
I'm the record holder of the most ever credits from someone graduating from LCHS.
Wow.
So, you know, that's almost worth something. I don't know if it's to this day. I haven't gone back and checked it in the last 20 years.
You should, though.
I imagine that somebody has fucked up more than me, right?
Yeah, that has to have happened. It's quite possible that a child from someone in our class was that fuck up there. So.
Sure, very, very possible, man. So back to the film. Where does it go next? How do people support it and see it?
Yeah, we just this last weekend did our North American premiere at Shriekfest, which is really cool, and down at Raleigh Studios in Hollywood.
Woo! Your neighbor.
Sure. Yeah, very close.
Yeah, that went really well, and we sold out three theaters, and it was crazy. They're turning it away. It was really really good, and now it's going back to where we shot it. Actually, it's going going to Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm. Strangely enough, the very same small town. Like, we had this itty bitty tiny little town out there in the middle of nowhere in Wisconsin. That's about 100 and some odd miles from any major city. They actually have a great film festival there.
Hmm.
And guess who's playing in that film festival? Yeah.
Elvis Presley.
Yes.
Elvis Presley is back.
The Stones.
He's back.
He's back. And larger than ever.
Okay, I feel that my guess was wrong.
Because of him, we're not in the festival.
Who are you guys trying to lead it to?
And of all places, Wisconsin.
Right.
What made you choose Wisconsin?
One of our cast members, who's also up there in the partner. Yeah. Sorry.
Way to undersell Derek.
Yeah. Hey, no.
He's probably watching.
Hey,
and he's
stoked. He's like, wow. He was one of the guys in the movie.
he
gave us some money.
He was the guy that with a chainsaw.
I knew it. This is so classic them. Anyway, so one of the cast members and a partner, Derek. He's from that small town in Wisconsin, and so when we decided to make an indie feature, we needed to have a place where we could do things inexpensively, and so he said, I think if we went there, you know, my family would rally behind the picture and help us get it made.
His family's from that town?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Like from,
so
like
the 100, they had to
back.
Get like the 100 people who live there,
exactly.
Like into a town hall,
everyone.
And said, hey,
absolutely,
and like
what happened.
Raise your hand kind of vote.
Yeah, so all of those folks that you saw in that little trailer kind of a thing, those were all local townies.
Yeah.
And so it was amazing. Like the entire town for like generations back, the Hoggins are from this town. And so everybody at the police department, they were the nicest people ever. They gave us food and they kept us warm. It was amazing.
It's
and
not every day that you get a movie show coming through and making a movie.
Cheese curds? Would you like some cheese curds there?
We'll get back to the other side of the story. On the other side, we have to go to a commercial break. I also want to talk about some other projects you guys are working on.
Yeah,
and,
man.
I think we're going to start with a clip from it on the other side of the break. So come on back in 2 minutes, guys.
Bring it back.
And I'm Nicole, and we're the ladies of Suicide Girls Radio, the world's leading BYOB radio show. Pour a glass of your favorite tipple and tune in on Wednesday nights between 8 and 9 p.m. as we discuss life, liberty, and the pursuit of free nipples. Oh, just flash it would be kind of funny, wouldn't it? People think flashing your tits is easy, right? And it's actually kind of hard.
Jason Stewart here for Zinna TV. On the show Absolutely Jason Stewart every Wednesday at 1 p.m. Big guests, everyone from the gayest to gay to the straightest to straight. David, what was his name?
He's absolutely Jason, he's absolutely gay, he'll absolutely brighten up.
And it's Mary Carey, of course, politically naughty with Mary Carey.
I'm always naughty. I'm always politically. My behavior is always politically
naughty.
I'm never politically correct.
Dr. Drew,
hi. Oh, I'm so
excited. How are you?
It's all teary-eyed, doctor.
I know. She wished she could live at rehab.
But only if Dr. Drew's there. Obviously, sure. Plus one, like, you know, because a little too groping might be inappropriate, but I like the flirting and stuff.
When I walked in, you shoved my head in your...
No! Are you going to sue me?
Get politically naughty with Mary Carey, Mondays at 4 p.m.
Want to see some real detective work?
want me to clean their balls?
Sniper! I became a cop for one reason and one reason only. To end crime forever. That hasn't happened yet.
Oh, damn.
Tone down the smile, Pixar. Shit's about to get real.
This deep cocking and dumping, the drama really means nothing to me. I ride by and blow your brains out. It's no time to cock it. No way you can stop it when niggas run up on you with them things out. I do what I gotta do. I don't care if I get caught. The DA could play this motherfucking tape in court. I'll kill you.
I ain't playing.
Sometimes I think staying in tumbleweed and helping people out and doing the right thing is the only way to move forward in the game. But most of the time I'm pretty much just like, fuck it.
Dial for your best baby ducker and a fresh pair of pants.
All right, we're back here on Grand Theft Audio Radio. This is Jake Belcher.
And I'm Brent Thoman.
And you guys just saw a couple of clips from these gentlemen's.
Hey!
Final other projects.
Good Cops and Tumbleweed.
Yeah.
Sure.
Both
what
very
got
funny.
Us the movie.
Yeah.
Right. What was the order of them? Like, how'd things come down?
We started off with Good Cops.
Mm-hmm.
Jake, this is the one you can take on. How did we get into Good Cops?
Oh, it was an inside joke that everybody told us not to do.
Including me,
Noel, and Derek came up with these ridiculous characters that whenever we would hang out, we would have drinks and we would pretend to be these good cops, you know, lean against a fridge and say, I'm a good cop, damn it,
hilarious.
You know?
Yeah.
And we thought it was hilarious. Our wives didn't think it was very funny. Nobody thought it was very funny. And then one day we decided, let's put this on the internet, and we told Clayton, and he didn't think it was a good idea either.
It's a horrible idea.
And,
we got him out.
But we sent him a script of the first episode, which had a nice, crude joke at the end, and I think that's what sold it. And and so we started making good cops, and we made a deal. We said, if nobody watches this show after three episodes, we stop. We don't worry about it. We don't put any more energy on. But we put the first three online, and then this company called Machinima contacted us and said, we love the show. We want to sign with you guys. And then that opened up a season two of Good Cops, and then that led us to Tumbleweed. And
they actually bought the show, and then did fully funded the second season.
Wow.
And got a bunch of money and went out and made the whole second season for Machinima Prime, which was one of the YouTube original channels. And that thing went nuts. It went gangbusters. And then
so you guys showed them and you these three got good jobs. People will watch.
Talking about Oxfam.
And then Tumbleweed was his turn to do it to me. So Machinima, they talk about, they're saying, well, you know, do you have anything that's more video game oriented or whatever? And so
we're thinking about video games.
So we start pitching around these different ideas, and then I get a call from these guys. And like it's late, I'm tired, and my job's to worry about money usually. That's what the producer's problem is, right? So I got a call from these guys. They're like, oh, we've got the best idea.
Yeah. You ever have a game called Red Dead Redemption?
we basically the pitch was, listen, there's a lot of Western props out there in costumes, so it'll be cheap and easy.
Yeah.
But we should
make a good
Western
selling point.
That's what I thought.
I like that.
And, you know, a couple months later, we were in the desert shooting with guns and horses and lovely ladies dressed
it
as women of the night.
It looked like a fun location. Did you guys find like a ghost town?
Was that also in Wisconsin?
That was here. That was close to Palm Springs.
Yeah, 29 Palms.
Oh, wonderful place.
White Horse Ranch, it's called.
Oh, man, the place is amazing.
Really, really cool spot. There's a guy named German Pete who's just constantly expanding it. He has all this space out there, and he's making the town bigger and bigger and bigger.
And it's all practical. It's the weirdest thing. Like, normally you go to, like, the Melody Ranch or some place like that, and, like, these places are like shells.
Sure.
Everything there is real and working, like, the interiors, exteriors. He is, like, he's got all the props and the sets and the set dressing and the costumes. Yeah. I'm like, wow, this is a dream come true.
One stop
Western shooting for him, and not in the bad way.
Yeah, we were there for a week, and every night we slept in some of the saloons, like, on the roof, and we would have, like, whiskey under the stars. So it was kind of an amazing week of our lives.
It's unreal. Because, you finish the day of shooting, and then there's a giant fire going. And then everyone's roasting marshmallows, drinking whiskey, and then you get on the roof, and there's...
And we only shot during the day, because, you know, and then we only have so many hours. So as soon as the sunset goes down, you're like, well, we're done. You want to go camping? And it was the greatest job in the world.
It was cool.
So cops, Western, horror.
Yeah.
Are you guys shooting something now or comedy? Next?
Sci-fi, maybe?
We do want to make a sci-fi.
We have an idea for something that we'll make eventually for that one. Yeah. Sci-fi.
Yeah.
We're gonna go back to the web. We're not technically allowed to officially announce, but we're going back to the web for our next one, and it may or may not
be a continuation
of a genre piece that was done before.
Yes.
Cool, man. Yes, yeah. Okay, so where can people follow you guys to learn more about the upcoming project?
Sure. On Good Cops TV. So it's, if you go to YouTube, Good Cops TV, or Facebook/Good Cops TV, or Twitter.com/Good Cops TV. If you want to follow the movie, it's all House Harker.
Yeah, all you got to do is search House Harker and you'll find it.
Where are you guys headed next with that? Do you have another? I know you're heading back to Wisconsin. But you got another?
We're partners with a company called Shoreline Entertainment.
Okay.
And they're a pretty huge, cool company. And their job is with us is to worry about problems like that. And they keep us perfectly in the dark for just long enough until it's time, and then it's like, go.
Hey, in about 3 days, we need you to go to Japan.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, crap.
We know that there's a couple more international spots by, like, Australia and so on that we're heading towards, and then more in the U.S. But also, luckily enough, we keep picking up distributors everywhere we go.
Yeah.
So once we get enough distributors going, then it'll get released, and then the festivals won't want us anymore, and so we won't have to travel anymore.
check us out in theaters and in Netflix and all that stuff.
Congrats on you guys' success.
Yeah,
especially
you so
couple
much.
La Cunada guys. I always like to see that, coming from the hard streets.
Streets of the LC, baby.
I'll still celebrate someone from Montrose.
The LCF, baby.
I'm an honorary
member.
That's
right. Haha Mugga Watershed Park for life.
Sure. Play some Frisbee golf. Okay, so we have one more segment on the show where we kind of goof off. Would you guys like to stick around for it?
We would love to goof off.
Are you kidding?
Great. We'll come back on the other side. And I was home watching. I got rid of my cable. Like, I finally got rid of AT&T U.
Right. Good.
And,
congratulations.
I was streaming some stuff on my Roku, and they had this screen up of captions to describe a movie for you to order it.
Oh, awesome.
And what they wrote was effing crazy on these movies. So we're going to come back. We're going to talk about those.
Nice.
And we'll probably cover one or two holidays. So come back in 2 minutes, guys.
It's on.
Sexy, what do you say? And all the ladies say. And all the ladies say. Think I like that. And all the ladies say. Now if you living that life the way you living, can't live it no other way. I need you to put a bottle in the air right now. Welcome to the champagne life. Where trouble is a bubble in a champagne glass. Dreams and reality are one and the same. Don't act like you don't know the name. And we gon' do it like this. Let's go. Got an addiction for life in this baby. Like every day is my birthday. No, but I'm kidding.
should be killed. There is a way out. There is a way off the street. Not tomorrow, but now. Runaway Hotline will get you off the street. Call Runaway Hotline, toll free, anytime, day or night. Runaway Hotline gets your message to those who care. Call now and get off the street.
Dude, that is
amazing. Do you need a mic or do we
If you have any teenage runaway girls, please recommend this podcast, vodcast to them so they can watch it. And then find that number to help get them off the street. This is what we're helping.
It's a roundabout way of getting ladies off the street. So.
Sure. We're back here on Grand Theft Audio on Zynna.tv. This is Jake Belcher.
And I'm Brant Thoman.
And still in studio with us are...
Jacob Givens.
Clayton Cogswell.
Noel Carroll.
Notice next to Brant that there's someone else who's shown up on screen.
Desperately handsome man.
Sure, sure. hey, Brant, why don't you introduce who this is?
This guy next to me,
Put it like between you two and like lean
I'll give it back to him when I'm done.
Are we back to being a dick show?
No, but this is our brother's tree. Yeah, exactly. This is the Big Brother show. So, yes. Yes. I've known this one, unfortunately, for 38 years.
His entire life.
His entire life. It's been that. Most of mine. This is my younger brother, Richard Thoman. Yay,
Richard Thoman, everybody.
Hi.
Hey, Richard. Nice to see you here, man.
Great.
He plays a really good ex-priest.
In our film.
He's actually in our movie.
So wait. Was he... was that?
I was working.
Oh, yeah, that's
you were,
right.
Yes,
you
yes,
were
yes.
And then also you were an ex.
Talk in the microphone or they can't hear you.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Sorry. I was actually a working priest. That
right.
Went crazy.
Yeah. That's right. Thank you. That's how radio works.
Yes.
Exactly.
Wow. See, I knew this was going to be the dick show.
This
all
is
right,
my
guys.
First time, everybody.
Sure. But we'll be very gentle. Okay, so I was watching TV. You guys have those movie things. I want to put, like, let's put the first one up on the screen, and let me show you, like, this person's sense of humor, because these are wonderful. Okay. Mm-hmm. Alice Through the Looking Glass. It says, stars Johnny Depp, Helena Bonham Carter, Stephen Fry, Anne Hathaway, Alan Rickman, and Borat.
I'm sure he really appreciated that.
Didn't even use his real name.
Nice. Yeah.
Now You See Me Too.
Oh, God.
How the heck are you? Are these clowns supposed to beat Harry Potter at magic? That's awesome.
What?
Okay, The Secret Life of Pets. I make the same face about an hour after eating Chipotle. I can't believe that he wrote that on there.
This is
legit.
What app is this that you're watching this stuff?
It's called Video Stream, and it's like through my Roku. And they put these things on here trying to entice you to buy these movies. Yeah, throw that Ninja Turtle one again, man.
So what?
They're literally the stuff of nightmares.
It's a beloved franchise.
On the road. Wait, I don't understand.
So they want you to, like, pay money to rent these movies?
But that's that's the slug line
the
that they're throwing at the top.
The tagline they put on that?
Yeah.
Some dude wrote?
Yes.
That's... I'm buying a Roku.
It's worth it for these alone. They're literally the stuff of nightmares. We have one more of them, I think. Mechanic Resurrection. Jason Statham plays a mechanic who thinks he's Spider-Man.
I'm actually really fond of that one.
Yeah, yeah. I think the last one is Tarzan, right?
Yeah.
Let's see if we got the Tarzan one. Chest out for Harambe.
Oh, dude. Oh, no.
Wow.
It's a Redditor.
This guy
is
really
amazing.
He's really earning his money.
This is like Mystery Science Theater meets like Netflix.
I know. Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
That's amazing.
And honestly, I was so stoned when I was watching it that I thought I was making it up in my mind.
Yeah.
I had to like watch it again. I'm like, no, someone's really pulled
in his brain. The memes were coming up. It's like, did I really write that? Did I just think that?
Like, oh, I'm a genius.
Yeah. Sure.
Yes. Yeah.
Chest out for Harambe. Okay, there's one more, right? There's Ghostbusters, I think. Ghostbusters has one more.
Oh, no.
It's not that bad. Actually, it's pretty gentle.
Nice and gentle.
Yeah. I ain't afraid of no reboots.
That's pretty gentle.
You know, that's actually something that sounds like they would have come up with.
Yeah, that doesn't say anything that's about like ladies aren't funny or like those
they're
things.
A little careful on that one. Yeah.
Sure, sure. They should be because ladies are hilarious.
Yes.
They are.
They're hilarious. All right, the last thing we do here on Grand Theft Audio, we like to look at holidays.
That's right.
Because every day, every month, every week, there's something that they want you to either commemorate or acknowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Or
recognize.
A lot of recognize.
Represent.
Yep. Right.
Today is the...
No, not so much represent, just the recognize.
October. The 12th of October brings us Drink Local Wine Day.
Oh, that means we go down to the San Antonio Winery here in L.A. We get to drink their fine product.
Okay, look, I don't want to say, okay, look, that that stuff is shit. Like, I used to like kind of live with a family that manufactures it, and they know it's shit.
Yes.
So, like,
yeah. The only place I ever see it is back in the kitchen to be used for cooking wine.
This episode was not sponsored by San Antonio.
But if you're interested, you can give us a call at that number on the commercial that they had for the runaway hotline phone. That's also for anyone who wants to sponsor us. So San Antonio Wine Company, please.
Drink
please,
local
we
wine.
Need it.
I will reject your cash because I know that that is like blood money that you guys have made.
Money.
So no, thank you. And you're also fellow members of the Tournament of Roses. So hello. Okay, here's what we got. I'm gonna rip through these last ones. Today is also Free Thought Day. So
all right.
I think we're celebrating that's what we're doing.
That's nice.
Today's Emergency Nurses Day. Those nurses who work in the
emergency room.
Oh man, they pull back that that big curtain and like
night nurses from Jersey, man.
Yeah.
I've
and
seen
and
that.
And
about
those
15
orthopedic
times.
Shoes, fucking sexy.
Yeah, man.
Wait, there's a lot of them today. Today is also National Take Your Parents to Lunch Day.
Oh, no.
Well, I blew that one.
That
blew
it.
Sure. But next year on the 12th, you can celebrate that. Sure. We have a Spanish Language Day. Chupa mi verga. I think that means like bring me a drink.
That's exactly
what it means.
That is 100%.
I'm fairly certain it means that.
Down in Guadalajara, that's what they taught him.
God damn it. This is also World Arthritis Day. You guys worried about arthritis at all?
Oh, thank God. I was
not yet why I was feeling this way today.
I'm nervous about it because like I use my phone all the time and I feel that my thumbs are more tired than they should be.
That's not why your thumbs are tired.
Yeah.
I separated my shoulder playing soccer. Doc thinks I got a good shot at arthritis.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
All right.
Congratulations.
I'm rooting for you.
Noel and his future.
I'm rooting for you.
Thank you.
We've also got Stop America's Violence Everywhere Day.
Everywhere?
Everywhere?
Oh my God!
That's the slug line
crime
of
forever.
Are in Good Cops.
That is actually our slug line.
That's actually
the slug
line. Crime forever.
That's the goal of the Good Cops. I can't believe there's a day
end
for us.
End crime forever.
So this is our day.
What day is it? No, but it's
October
10th. It's violence, right?
It's today.
Today.
End violence.
Holy crap, today is
end crime
forever. I
cannot believe we didn't put that up.
To end violence. So does that mean we got to stop the animals from doing it too?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, just for a day.
If you video it and you put it on the internet for money, like you're allowed to watch animals fight.
Yeah.
But otherwise, it's immoral.
But only if it's for money, it's not
immoral.
Quiet,
you!
Sorry.
No, because I was going to claim.
Shut up also!
I was going to claim Antarctica.
Shut up!
There's nothing down there.
Hey,
I've already cleared an entire
your
continent.
Your words are garbage to me. Your words are garbage.
Oh, it's actually words are garbage to me day too.
It's actually I'm going to quit right now because it's Stop Bullying Day. And so I'm going to stop bullying.
Great.
And I'm going to thank you. I'm going to step back.
That was masterful.
Thank you.
You must do this.
Sure. Stop bullying, guys. It doesn't make people stronger like I say it does. It probably makes people cry at night.
Sure.
And,
sure.
You know,
doesn't build character.
Can I try that?
Sure.
You're right. It doesn't work.
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
Not today. I mean, you tried,
not this day.
You got no.
And
not in our house. Yeah. All right, guys. That's all the things we're celebrating for today. There's a whole bunch of other things for October and other things for the week, but I'm kind of done reading that list.
I had this great idea for a segment, and then I decided I don't like it anymore.
I looked over, and then I kind of caught a glimpse of myself looking over on the camera. And I'm like, I don't like the way I look looking over there.
Oh.
So like, we gotta move that camera just that way, and then I'll start looking that way again.
Yeah.
But okay. Until then,
sure. Until that
monitor is dead to us.
Yeah.
Forget it. That's what I'm gonna say. All right, Jacob. Where can people learn more about you specifically? You got Twitter, all that jazz?
I absolutely do. I'm a stand-up comic here in L.A., so at Jacob Givens, you can find me pretty much on every site.
He's really funny. What do you really do for a living?
I hustle.
Bartender?
I hustle. I work at NBC Universal. That's how I pay the bills.
All right.
Clayton?
I do have a Twitter. I never check it. Mm-hmm. I apologize.
Yeah, he's not a social media guy.
But I'm not a social media guy. I follow the Christopher Nolan thing of just being a Luddite. And all that stuff, but
you're so fancy.
Not even Facebook.
I do have Facebook.
Yeah, there we go.
If you follow
but
me
you
on Facebook, I will not follow you back.
Don't want a bunch of weirdos following.
Yeah,
you put your kids up there.
Yeah,
sure.
That's
not
fun. Yeah, I you can follow me on Noeltron, Noeltron, on pretty much everything.
Yeah.
How about you, Richard? Anything people follow you on?
Don't give him the microphone.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, sure. I get intimidated when I sit next to him also. I get it, man.
No. It's why we sit across from each other.
Yeah.
The only way it works.
Yeah, sure. Brant, you have anything to pimp out this week?
Nothing.
Oh, nothing?
Nothing.
Okay. Well, I'd like to.
Does the show?
Yeah. Well, I'd like to point out one last thing. On here this season, I've been very complimentary towards Brant and his undefeated team and how good he's been at fantasy football.
Yes.
Hey.
Congratulations.
Right.
Thank you.
This week we meet. And I want to wipe my ass with you, motherfucker!
Sure.
You're going down!
No, I'm not.
Wait,
do you have the players to do it?
Yeah. I'm projected to beat them.
Yeah.
Yes. So
that felt a little like bullying to me. I'm sorry.
Well, the day's over, bitch.
This is game. This is gamesmanship.
This is real life fantasy football action.
I love D&D.
If it's
for
about
jocks,
sports, it's
sure,
it's so
sure.
fun.
Honestly, dude, I'm not gonna miss a single tackle this week.
Sure, you're not. You're not gonna make your defense. Not gonna make any either.
Oh, I bet they do.
I'm sure they will.
I mean, because that's a
who's your defense?
That was a silly thing.
Your
to
defensive
say.
Linemen, all your defensive players.
Who's your defense?
Okay, I'm rocking Buffalo right now.
That's all right.
Yeah, he dropped Minnesota last week. Yeah.
What is wrong with you?
What's wrong with me?
Because he don't know what he's doing.
Right.
Well, but he's still winning.
You're 2-3.
You're
2-3 right now.
2-3. That's right.
Okay.
Doing the victory dance.
4-1.
Sure.
I did take my first loss, absolutely.
But this weekend, you're going to take another loss.
Nope.
Yeah, you are. Would you like to make a friendly wager on it?
Sure. What's the friendly wager?
Okay. How about the winner gets to bring in something unpleasant for the loser to drink on the air next week.
Well, not next week.
Okay, 2 weeks from now,
because
you won't be here.
That's right, I can't
be
here.
I'm going to give you a glass of crab juice or something that no one would ever want to drink.
Sure.
Sure. Are you good with that?
Sure, why not?
Sure. Hey!
Yeah.
We got it on camera. They know. All right, party people. It's Dick Week, right?
I think that was one of the things.
Thanks for watching the Dick Show, the Dick Show episode of Grand Theft Audio. I guess.
What he said.
Yeah.
Oh,
bye.
I'm feeling
guys.
Feeling
get out of here.
Thanks so much.
Oh.
Fade out.
Yeah.